Well, Mark, thanks for talking to us. Firstly, you must be delighted with that win tonight.
Well, it's a huge one, especially the, you know, losing the, in Fife last night and the points we dropped against Edinburgh. So it's tight in our group, you know, looking at the other results. I think it's a five-way tie for first right now in our group after the results. But those are 2 points we needed. And to get against a team like Braehead, it's huge. Huge for momentum for us going into the season. And, you know, if we want to win a conference, we've got to go through a team like that.
Yeah, I mean, you say that. I mean, the quality and strength and depth that Braehead have got, it's an even better achievement, isn't it, for when Dundee can really match them and play like that?
Yeah, I mean, we just, you know, we're a little bit Jekyll and Hyde right now. I'm just trying to find some consistency every night, and we're a bit of a roller coaster right now. We're good for one match, and then we're poor the next match. And, you know, against Nottingham, Belfast, the Manchester game tonight, you know, it seems against the bigger clubs that we step up the play, and we got to find that consistency all the way through.
Yeah, I mean, what do you think the crucial differences were between last night and tonight?
Well, last night I thought we were very perimeter. You know, I watched the film this morning when I got up, and you know, Fife went right to the net. I mean, we only gave up 24 shots last night, which is pretty good. But the difference was they went to the dirty areas to score goals, whereas they kept us to the outside, and we were very perimeter. We didn't want to go to the dirty areas to score goals. And tonight was a little bit of a difference. We battled harder in front of our own net, which created to our first goal. We went to the net for a rebound on Michael's goal. And you know, Bobby went to the dirty area for a nice goal in the second one.
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot of standout performances, clearly, to win a game like that tonight. But the third line, how impressed are you with what they're doing at the moment?
You know, they don't get all the accolades, those guys. I mean, Faryna, I mean, to step up like he did, Swiss was great. I think Swiss, you know, he's been our most consistent player, I think, throughout the season. He's a first-year guy. Michael, you know, he doesn't get in the score sheet. I was happy for him to score tonight because, you know, he was chomping at the bit there to get one. And it was nice to see him score. But those are kind of the, you know, the unsung heroes for our club that you're going to need to win games.
Talking to other unsung heroes, Craig Moore as well. He had a great game tonight, yeah?
He's getting better every day. You know, playing with a veteran guy like Jason, he is in the back end. And, you know, if we do get a bit of penalty trouble, I can put him up front and on the third line. And he does a good job there. And you know what? He's killing penalties. 20-year-old kid, first-year pro. I have no problem putting him out there on the penalty kill. So I have a lot of confidence in him. And he's going to get better every day.
Does when you give a player like that confidence and the belief, do you think that helps the Craig in terms of going out there confidently, putting in them kind of performances?
Well, you know, we're not a deep enough team, so I got to use everybody. I got to use our bench, and you know, like I said, practicing with pros every day, being around pros, you know, it's going to give him confidence to become a better player. And you know, I think we're just starting to see what he can really do, and it's exciting for us.
Yeah, and of course the games roll thick and fast. Sheffield next weekend, here next weekend. I'm sure you'll be looking forward to that one.
You know what? They're the hottest team in the league right now. If anyone told you any different, they're definitely not watching the same league we are. You know, they're well coached. They're well structured. They got everybody rolling right now. You know, we're going to find a way. We're going to find a way like we did tonight to win a hockey game there. We know we're in for a battle, and we're looking forward to it.
And if we can just get a message for the fans, because they've certainly been busy this week, as well as the players, bingo nights, coffee mornings, and then the fans turning up in the massive numbers they did last night and tonight. Have you got a message for them?
No, just thanks. Keep supporting the guys. I mean, the guys love it. You know, we're a smaller club, and we need all the support we can get. And it's, you know, it's nice. They really rallied around the guys tonight when we needed it after last night. And the guys really appreciate it.
That's great. Mark, best of luck next weekend. Thank you.
Thanks very much.
I thought it was a big win for us. I mean, last night was a little disappointing. So to come back and respond and win against a top team like that feels pretty good.
Absolutely, what Hart said there. Just shows character this team has to bounce back from a kind of a tough road trip yesterday.
Yeah, and Justin, man of the match as well.
It was a team effort though. Obviously a tight game, 2-1. Feels good. And, yeah.